Mastercam 3D high-speed waterline toolpaths are typically used for finishing and semi-finishing operations. Constant Z slices are applied along the model and are best suited for surfaces whose angles are roughly between 30 and 90 degrees. In Mastercam 2024, we've enhanced this toolpath to provide better control and efficiency. Let's take a look with some examples. As we can see from this example here, we have a stock model followed by an OptiRough toolpath and then another stock model. We then flip the part over and again have an OptiRough toolpath to rough out the model, followed by another stock model. With the part being roughed out on both sides, we'll apply a waterline toolpath using the stock model to reference our existing stock. If we take a look at what happens here, we see that we have unnecessary tool motion below the part, as that material was removed in a previous operation. Specifically, we have a lot of extra motion cutting air below the part. Let's hide our retract motion so we can further investigate our toolpath. Now, we could address this with some adjustments, such as adding a depth value to our maximum Z depth parameter, but that's setting a depth for the entire toolpath, so we might still have some localized areas where we're cutting air. Let's copy this operation and explore some new functionality. Back in the toolpath parameters under Stock, we see this option here, Detect Stock Breakthrough. This will help eliminate unnecessary air cuts as the toolpath is now looking at the stock. While we're here, let's also enable another new feature, Allow Partial Cuts. This adds or removes tool motion only from the shallow areas of the part and does not create a complete pass around the part. Let's click OK and investigate the impact that these new features have on the toolpath. First, we see those partial cuts we just enabled. There are smaller partial cuts in the shallow areas, and this helps provide a more uniform model for finishing. As we mentioned earlier, they are partial passes and do not completely pass around the part. Now for the Detect Stock Breakthrough setting. Here, we see that the toolpath is removed in areas where there is no stock below a previous pass. This increases the efficiency of the waterline tool motion by eliminating the extra air passes. Now, if this setting, Detect Stock Breakthrough, seems familiar to you, that's because a similar option exists for dynamic OptiRough and area roughing toolpaths. And with this functionality being added to the waterline toolpath, we have even more control over the toolpath when working with stock models.